And back for the final round, we are once again going on the draw, and once again have a hand that can play a turn to Garrick's Companion. Definitely not mulliganing this. I don't know what my... Oh, my opponent's the mono black deck. He's got multiple Aquatic Sickness, he's got Captivating Vampire. Could be a tough matchup for us. I don't anticipate being able to beat him if he... Because we don't have enough removal. We really have to draw a Pyroclasm or something similar. He's got, yeah, an Antuco Shade. This deck's pretty sick. Watching the replays, I was impressed, but... We'll see, He had this start against other people. He's got, like I said, multiple Quag Sickness. I saw Nightwing Shade. It's a pretty fast start from him. I didn't see any artifacts from him, so I'm going to run this out there to trade with the Barony Vampire. I'd rather trade it than the Garrick's Companion, of course. We really need to, like, draw a Pyroclasm and catch him tap down, and we have a pretty good shot, but... This is probably Quag Sickness here, I would guess. Crystal Ball. Card's quite good. Alright, well, the good news is we get to rid ourselves of that Nantuco Shade. I think if I just attack, that's probably better, though. So I'm just going to get my attack on, see what happens. I could probably kill the Nantuco Shade anytime with this Lightning Bolt, so... I'd rather play the Candy Minotaur this turn and let him attack me and waste some mana. He's only got two cards left, so... If I can go on the offensive, it seems better for me. At this point, I probably throw... There's a Quag Sickness. I was going to say I throw Wall of Vines in front, but now I'm not, obviously. I'm just going to Lightning Bolt. So he's got another land in hand, I would guess. Unless he... Did he put both on top? Yeah, I put both on top, so he doesn't care. I mean, I guess I attack first, give him the least amount of information possible. So he's definitely favored right now. Now that I know he has a Crystal Ball, I'm obviously going to save my Manic Vandals. I have two of them, so should be good for us. Him scrying doesn't really matter here, since we know he has a card on top. We have plenty of bombs to get our way out of this, but him having Crystal Ball is a pretty big advantage. Well, now he put it on the bottom. Before he had it on top, and now it's on bottom, so... What could that be? It's probably a removal spell. And he wants to draw a creature first, so he bottomed it. Be my guess. But he's also stuck on only four lands, so he's not going to be playing anything too threatening. And he went top-bottom there, so he split him. I will discard two forests. That's probably better for him than he realizes just because of my seven drops. But it's also good to know he has a mine rot. No reason to keep that guy in hand. He is at 13, still choked on mana. This card's obviously going to pull him out. He went top there. Yeah, a land, probably Gravedigger or something. Child of Night. I'm not going to go on the offensive here. I don't see a reason to. I'm just going to play my land in case I draw a Guy's Revenge or something. And pass. He's probably going to start pulling away here, unless we can get some nice runners. We have drawn 9 lands already, so we have half our lands gone. That card's a beating. We're being told to smash him by somebody. There's a Fauna Shaman. That's a good one. Now any creature we draw, we get to cherry pick a little bit. Obviously, the first card we would grab would be Ancient Hellkite, I think. He's got no cards in hand. He's got the Crystal Ball they could find a Quag Sickness for or something, but Ancient Hellkite would shut him down, kill his team. Actually, the first card we'd find probably be Manic Vandal. I don't know, I'll have to do some math. Depends how much damage we're getting hit for. Only 2, so he's got a huge spell to play here. We're being corrupted. I see. So all that talk was moot, and we drew a land anyway. I'm going to go ahead and attack with my Land of Whirl for this point. If he wants to trade with Viscera Seer, that's fine. Not looking good for the home team. We could draw a Plummet and be fine. And we have a lot of good draws. Any of our big creatures, minus the 2 blue ones, of course. Plummet. Pyroclasm would be pretty bad unless he taps out. Which I suppose he could. Just to get in for more damage. He's not, so he's probably got a 4 or 5 drop, obviously. It's not a 3 drop. Oh. Alright, well, we drew our Plummet just in time to be mocked by Nantuko Shade. Gonna attack with his Land of Wealth because there's no reason not to. And since there's also no reason not to, I'm not gonna waste our Plummet until he starts spending mana on his guy. I don't feel like taking 1,000, so I'm going to throw this in front of there. Hopefully he'll just pump this dude a bunch. Maybe we can pump it the full 3 times and not use his crystal ball, would be my hope. He did not, but that's okay. At this point, a Pyroclasm is not even the greatest for us, since it won't kill the Shade. Alright, well, it's like drawing 2 lands at this point, so it makes the chance of us drawing another land. I think we'll only have, like, let's see, that's 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So we have 7 lands left in our deck after this. I think at this point I'm going to go ahead and take a hit because it's going to be less likely that I can survive a hit later. And if I draw a Pyroclasm and he taps down big enough to be able to kill with Pyroclasm, that'll be good for us. The max we could take here is 8, so let me break this in an F6. I didn't want to give away that we were getting an island, but that's fine. He probably watched the replays. Alright, so Pyroclasm's a good one for us, and any creature really is fine. Or we could draw a mountain. Which is not as good. Gonna have to chump block this turn. crystal ball is definitely a thing that's tearing us apart. I mean, we had two manic vandals and I guess a clone that could have killed it, but I mean, not really a clone. At this point, a clone, but before earlier, or before, we obviously couldn't have had a clone since we don't have a blue mana. We're currently dead next turn and double dead now. I don't know. I know he has another Quack Sickness. He could have like a Corrupt or something. And we drew two Mountains, so I guess we'll see what he plays. See if he tutored for Quack Sickness or not. We knew we were passing a pretty sick mono black deck. And like the benefits. The benefits of that are that, you know, you're giving somebody else a good deck. And you hope to not face them in the finals, so we did about as well as we could in this case. Alright, Hornet Sting seems good. For sure. He's got Viscera Seer, Child of Night, Nantuko Shade that he's been pumping down. What other cards do we have? Thunderstrike could be valuable. Bringing all the cards that could be good. And Whisper So Cloak is not that great. As far as cards we're taking out, Plummet is probably not super exciting against them, but we don't have enough removal to really take it out. The clone I could take out, I suppose. We're not going to be able to copy any of his creatures for value, and copying our own seems not that exciting. The Wall Vine's also not that exciting. That looks like it. I think I'm going to leave the Thunderstrike out for now and just bring in the two Hornet Stings. Let's see if that works out for us.